if you don't do what I want you to do, there's guns involved. I was scared. I did what they wanted me to do.
Angiie was forced into prostitution when she was 15 years old.
What was a typical day like for you?
No less than like 25 guys.
In a day?
In a day.
Angiie wants to keep her identity private, but she is sharing her story with us in the hopes of helping other young girls. She says she was living in a foster care group home in Queens when she was abducted at gunpoint near the home.
The guys jumped out, four of them, and they just grabbed me and put me in the van. They took me to a basement, and like less than an hour, there was already a customer.
The foster care home reported to police that Angiie was missing, but her captors wanted to make sure people would not recognize her.
They cut my hair. They changed my hair color. I was, you know, naturally brownish. They changed me to a blonde. I looked more Japanese than anything. My face looked fatter because of the haircut.
She says the pimps, a man and a woman, sold her for sex, even crossing state lines.
We went to Jersey. We went to Pennsylvania, we went to Maryland.
And Angiie says her pimps beat her when she refused to try and recruit younger girls.
These girls were around like middle school age, 12, 13, and they tried to get me to convince them to become prostitutes.
Within a couple of months of being abducted, a clerk at a Brooklyn hotel recognized Angiie as the missing girl and called police. That is when the NYPD's human trafficking team entered Angie's life.
Hey, what's up?
What's going
on? What do we got today?
Lieutenant Christopher Sharp is the commanding officer of the Vice Enforcement Division human trafficking team.
Okay. The average age for a commercial sex exploitation is 13 years old. We've had a case where we did a rescue as young as a 12-year-old girl in a hotel room.
Lieutenant Sharp uses the word rescue because the NYPD is no longer arresting girls and boys for prostitution under the age of 18. And for those 18 and over, an arrest is determined on a case-by-case basis.
We understand you're a trafficking victim. We're going to try to help you.
In 2016, the NYPD changed its approach to dealing with prostitution and began connecting victims with counselors and social services agencies to help guide survivors out of forced prostitution. New York courts have been taking that same approach since 2013, creating human trafficking courts statewide, the first in the country.
It's people really in need of help and not in need of a criminal conviction and a traditional punishment.
Judge Charlotte Davidson says there is staff in the courthouse to immediately help sex trafficking victims.
Whether that means helping them find housing, giving them counseling, treatment for trauma, health care, education, job training, job placement.
And as part of its new approach, the NYPD has also joined forces with the FBI and Homeland Security, using artificial intelligence to go after the Johns, the men buying sex.
We now live online.
The NYPD is using bots to post fake ads online for sex, and the bots are having conversations with the potential buyers.
These are some of the comments over that people are responding. Hey, sweetie, are you available for a call tonight for an out call? What are your prices?
The bots are also in Spanish. And once a John responds to the fake ads with his cell phone, he gets a surprise text message.
This is what comes up on their phone.
Correct.
In a text message saying, hey, we're NYPD human trafficking team.
Correct.
And the Johns now realize the NYPD knows who they are. And if they show up for a date, they will be arrested. Last year, the NYPD sent more than 6,000 of these texts.
We are making buyers aware, hey, listen, you have a lot to lose. And that is the only way to get the buyers out of the market.
The NYPD has also trained its 5,000 school safety agents to spot behavior that could signal a student is being trafficked for sex. Something as simple as having two cell phones.
Some of those phones are working numbers. That's the working phone. That's for the business.
So when people think about this stuff going on, they think of some dark, dingy, run-down, crime-infested neighborhood, but that's not always the case.
No, it's not. It happens everywhere.
NYPD Lieutenant Joe Agresta says no community, including the suburbs, is immune from possible sex trafficking.
And they're actually recruiting some of these girls from inside the schools, like some students are recruiting other students.
Yes, it goes on, and they recruit girls. They're recruited from all different places. Their homes, online. There's a lot of girls on social media.
And remember Angiie? Well, with the help of the NYPD's human trafficking unit, she was able to testify before a grand jury against her pimps. And that man and woman went to prison. She also continues to have a close relationship with the female detective who helped guide her out of forced prostitution.
As of right now, she's more of like a mentor. If I need to ever vent, like, I'll call her. It doesn't matter what time.
Angiie, who is now 20 years old, is also going to college at CUNY to become either a social worker, therapist, or a police officer to help other sex trafficking victims.
You're not the only one. You have the support. Someone cares.
And there is also a big misconception that most of the girls and the women in prostitution are actually brought here from other countries. But law enforcement says, and really listen closely to this, 80% of the people charged with prostitution here in the U.S. are born in the U.S. Now, if you or anybody that you know has been forced into prostitution and you need help, there is help out there for you. You can call the NYPD's trafficking hotline number. That number is 646-610-7272, or you can even email them at ved@nypd.org.
A brave woman to share that story.
Really,
that
is brave.
Horrifying.
And she has to have, as we were just talking about, a lot of strength to be able to do that and to move forward in a positive
way. And want to help others.
And want to help other people. That's right.
Thank you, Linda.
Thanks, Linda.